Hello friends, welcome to the world's first YouTube cooking show from a village. I am Nikunj Osoy and today I am going to show you a restaurant style recipe of butter paneer masala or paneer makhni. It is a very easy recipe and it will give the same taste as you get in any Indian restaurant. So let's take a look at the ingredients one by one. For the paneer butter masala, you will need 200 gram paneer cubes, 250 grams finely chopped onion, 200 gram tomatoes, 2 cubes of butter, 1 tablespoon oil, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 50 grams cashew nuts or kaju, 1 teaspoon of garam masala, 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon garlic and ginger paste, 1 teaspoon red chili powder, 100 ml milk, some freshly chopped coriander leaves and salt to taste. First of all, I am going to heat oil. Now our oil is hot enough, so I am going to add the onion first. I am adding 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder and tomatoes. Stir this very well and we have to cook it for 5 to 7 minutes. We have to stir it every now and then so it can be cooked perfectly. Now I am going to add the salt and sugar. Now our onion and tomato 50% cooked, so I am going to add garlic and ginger paste. Again give it a nice stir. Now I am adding little bit of water so we can make a nice gravy from it. Again stir this very well. Now it is perfectly cooked, so I am going to turn the heat off. And keep it aside for few minutes while we can make the puree of cashew nuts and milk. For the health purpose, I am not using heavy cream in this recipe. Instead of that, I am going to make the cream from the cashew nuts and milk. Now I am going to blend it and make it a smooth cream or paste from it. Cream is ready, so I am going to keep it aside and meanwhile we are going to make the puree from our onion and tomatoes. Now from our tomatoes and onion, I am going to add around 80% of it and to make a puree from it. 20% for the later use. Now we have to blend it and make a puree from it. It will be a base gravy for our Punjabi curry. Now our gravy is ready, so it is the time to make our final product, paneer butter masala. Now I am going to heat butter first. Now our butter is perfectly heated, so I am going to add the onion and tomato curry into it. In this, I am going to add the Punjabi garam masala, little bit of turmeric powder and red chili powder. Mix all the spices and ingredients very well. Now it is ready, so I am going to add our gravy in it. Now in this, I am going to add little bit of water so we can cook the paneer. Now I am going to add our paneer cubes. Let it simmer for 5 to 7 minutes. Now I am going to add the cashew nuts and milk puree. Give it a nice stir. Look at the color, it is looking absolutely delicious, you know. It is looking very much like a restaurant curry. And I hope it will give the same taste as we get in an Indian restaurant. We have to stir it every now and then so it don't stick to the bottom. Now it is perfectly cooked, so I am going to add some freshly chopped coriander leaves and turn the heat off. Now it is the time to serve my very special paneer butter masala, which is very much like a restaurant curry. And I promise you that nobody is going to believe you that you cook this curry at home. garnish it with few coriander leaves. You can serve this curry with roti, paratha or naan, whatever you like. I hope you have enjoyed this recipe. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. Hello and welcome to the exclusive cooking show of Indian recipes. In today's episode, you are going to see another exclusive recipe from my secret cooking book. I am Nikunj Vasoya and this is Everyday Special. In today's episode of Everyday Special, you are going to see a Gujarati speciality, the spring onion and tomato curry. In Gujarat, this curry is known as a dungri tomato saag. This curry is very easy to make and delicious in taste. So let's try cooking the Gujarati's favorite, spring onion and tomato curry. For this, you will need 1 cup chopped spring onion, 1 cup chopped tomatoes, 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon of asafoetida, 1/2 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of coriander and cumin seeds powder, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1.5 tablespoon of oil, some freshly chopped coriander leaves and salt to taste. First of all, I am going to heat oil in a pan. Now oil is hot, so I am going to add the mustard seeds and cumin seeds. Now add the tomatoes and immediately cover it. Now give it a nice stir. Now add the turmeric powder, salt and asafoetida. This curry is one of my favorite curry, you know why? So everything at our farm, so we can get the fresh onions and tomato anytime we want. Now cover it and cook it on a medium low heat for 2 minutes. Now our tomatoes are half cooked, so I am going to add the spring onions, add the red chili powder and coriander and cumin seeds powder too. Give it a nice stir. Look at the color, it looks so beautiful. So I am going to add the 1/2 teaspoon of sugar. Add some freshly chopped coriander leaves. So this is it, our Gujarati special spring onion and tomato curry is ready to serve. Now it is the time to serve, very easy to cook, very best in taste and totally fresh. Dungri tomato saag. You can serve this with the chapatis, but in Gujarat this curry is generally served with the rotla, bread made from the millet flour. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. Please don't forget to send me your feedbacks on this recipe. Subscribe to Don TV today for more exclusive recipe from Indian cuisine. Enjoy the exclusive and secret recipes only on Don TV. Thanks for watching. Hello friends, welcome to the world's first YouTube cooking show from a village. I am Nikunj Vasoya and today I am going to show you a very special and a very unique Gujarati dish which is known as a besan and palak curry or sabji, and it is very easy to make and you can make in just few minutes. So let's have a look at the ingredients one by one. For the spinach and besan curry you will need 2 bunch of chopped spinach or palak, 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds and cumin seeds, 1 tablespoon oil, 1 cup besan, 1 tablespoon garlic slices or chopped garlic, 1/2 teaspoon of sugar and salt to taste. First of all I am going to heat oil. Now our oil get heated, so I am going to add the mustard seeds and cumin seeds. When it started popping, add the garlic. Now I am going to add our spinach. Now I am going to add the sugar and salt to taste. Stir this very well and mix all the ingredients. Now I am going to cover it and cook it for 2 to 3 minutes on a medium low heat. After 2 to 3 minutes, when your half of the water get reduced, you can add the besan. Mix it very well. Again I am going to cover it for just 20 to 30 seconds. Again give it a stir so we can cook our besan perfectly. Now it is done, so I am going to turn the heat off. Now it is the time to serve my very special and authentic style Gujarati curry. You can serve this curry with the rotla or rotli, whichever you like. Rotla means a bread made from the millet flour, which is a Gujarati speciality, but I personally like to prepare it with the rotla. I hope you have enjoyed this recipe. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. Hello and welcome to the exclusive cooking show for Indian recipes. In today's episode, you are going to see another exclusive recipe from my secret cooking book. I am Nikunj Vasoya and this is Everyday Special. In today's episode of Everyday Special, you are going to see a restaurant recipe of mutter paneer or green peas and paneer curry. After working for a few years on the Punjabi curry, I have invented this original recipe of gravy for all Punjabi curries and has the same taste, color, but very best in digestion as compared to the other restaurant curries. So let's try cooking one of my favorite and simple, easy and delicious intense mutter paneer curry. For this you will need 750 grams roughly chopped onions, 5 tablespoon oil, 1 tablespoon garlic and ginger paste, 3 teaspoon red chili powder, 2 bay leaves, 500 grams tomatoes, 250 grams finely chopped onions, 250 grams chopped tomatoes, 2 teaspoon turmeric powder, 20 grams poppy seeds, 20 grams sesame seeds, 150 grams paneer cubes, 2 chopped green chilies, 1 teaspoon Punjabi garam masala, 100 grams green peas, few tablespoon cream, fresh coriander leaves and salt to taste. I am heating 1/2 jug of water. Add the onions and turmeric powder. Cook the onions for 10 to 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, it is the time to make puree from the onions. It looks delicious.
is the very, very important cooking procedure which people usually don't do at home while cooking the Punjabi curries. Add the onions into the very hot oil. This is nothing but we are cooking onion and tomato curry. It will help us to enhance the overall taste of the curry. Add green chilies and tomatoes. Mix this very well and add turmeric powder, red chili powder. Cook it for few minutes on a medium low heat. Now turn the heat off. First of all, we have to soak few ingredients into the bubbling hot water. This is the poppy seed, also known as khuskhus. This is around 20 grams. Stir it little with the spoon so it can be soaked nicely. This is the sesame seeds. This ingredient is a secret and usually people don't use this, but these poppy seeds and sesame seeds really good for our health, and also it will be the key ingredient to digest this curry very well. You have to soak both the ingredients for around 20 minutes. Add very hot water to the tomatoes so we can easily remove the skin of the tomatoes and make a nice puree. Now it is the time to make a creamy paste of poppy and sesame seeds. Add this to the onion puree. The skin of the tomato, and now it is the time to blend it. Add this with the other ingredients. Now it is the time to tell you another secret of cooking best curries. Into the 2 tablespoons of oil, add the bay leaves and gravy. First time on the web you are watching an original recipe of Punjabi curry. Add garlic and ginger paste. You have to keep stirring it. Now add the red chili powder. You have to cook gravy for 10 to 15 minutes on a medium low heat. So this is it, our secret gravy is ready. Now it is the time to show you the ultimate result that we can get by spending little extra time on cooking this curry. Add the onion and tomato curry. Add our beautiful gravy. Give it a nice stir. Now I am going to add the peas or mutter. Add little bit of red chili powder, salt and Punjabi garam masala. Okay, mix all the ingredients very well. I'm adding half glass of water. You can add the gravy and other veggies according to your taste. If you like gravy, then you can add gravy more as compared to the veggies. I mean, it's totally up to you. I like the peas, so I'm adding little extra. You have to stir it after every 30 seconds so it can be cooked perfectly. I am adding 3/4 spoon of Punjabi garam masala. Now the paneer cubes goes in and cream. There is no other alternative for the cream in this curry as it is a restaurant recipe. Look at the color, it looks simply awesome. Add some fresh chopped coriander leaves and turn the heat off. So this is it, our simple, easy and delicious mutter paneer curry is ready to serve. Now it is time to serve our gorgeous looking mutter paneer curry. You can serve it with the musky paratha, which is also invention of mine. Or onion bread. I think musky paratha goes good with this delicious curry. Garnish it with coriander leaf and fresh cream.
Hello friends, welcome to the world's first YouTube cooking show from Village. I am Nikunj Vasoya and today I am going to show you a authentic Gujarati rice potato curry recipe, which is important for any Gujarati thali. And you can't imagine any Gujarati restaurant menu without this potato curry. So let's take a look at the ingredients one by one. For the Gujarati style potato curry recipe, you will need 250 gram chopped potatoes. I have removed the skin of these potatoes and see the size, it is very important for the Gujarati curry. And we have around 2 tablespoons of oil, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seed, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon coriander and cumin seeds powder, 1/2 teaspoon asafoetida, 8 to 10 curry leaves, fresh coriander leaves, 1 medium sized chopped tomato and salt to taste. First of all, I am going to add the oil to the pan. Now our oil get heated, so I am going to add the mustard seed first. Then cumin seeds. Then I'm going to add the curry leaves. And immediately put the potatoes. Now add the turmeric powder. Now I'm going to cover it and cook it for a medium low heat for 2 to 3 minutes. You have to stir this after every minute so it can be cooked perfectly. Again cover it and cook it for 1 minute. Now I'm going to add 1 teaspoon red chili powder, half a teaspoon of asafoetida, and now I'm going to add the water. And salt to taste. Again I'm going to cover and cook it for 2 minutes. Now our potatoes are 75% cooked, so I'm going to add the tomatoes. Again stir this. And again I'm going to cover it and cook it for further 2 to 3 minutes. Now I'm going to add the coriander and cumin seeds powder. Now our curry is perfectly cooked, so now I'm going to add the coriander leaves. Now it is the time to serve our authentic style Gujarati curry made from the potatoes. You can serve this curry with the chapati or rice, whatever you like, but generally this curry comes with the chapatis in the Gujarati thalis. I hope you have enjoyed this recipe. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode.